Previously, we built an AM radio transmitter to get phone audio over the car's speaker, and it works. We have improved the car. But Tom, I can hear you asking, does it sound good? Of course not.
It sounds better with the door closed.
With Dave taking the Acty on a 6-hour drive in a day's time, we needed to make the transmitter an actual part of the car that you can turn on like any other component so he could listen to music on his trip. For that, we would have to remove the dashboard. And since he needs to drive it the next day, the instruments and steering wheel have to go back exactly the way they were so he doesn't, you know, die.
Do you have your phone volume turned up?
All the way.
Increase this. Yeah, you want to get it closer and see. Yeah, maybe we need to move it closer.
Maybe just put this on the seat.
There we go.
Ah.
Much better.
That sounds better.
Yeah, it should.
I think it's at 11. We can turn it up if we want.
Yeah.
That sounds pretty good.
It's just in Spanish for some reason.
So today we are doing what I would describe as exploratory surgery. We're removing the dash so that we can access the electronics and hook up our AM transmitter to the car's existing electronics. Doing this should teach us about the car's existing electronic systems. You know, that's kind of valuable considering we're going to be changing them.
I don't know what this is. It says warning. It says something about cold water. It says what you should do when you want to change the coolant. You do this, but I can't read this because it's Japanese.
Hey.
Look at that.
Yeah,
that's where the coolant goes in.
Oh, this thing here?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I bet that it opens and closes the vent. Let's see. No. There's a cable here. Oh, wait. There it is. That's for recirculation.
Oh, cool. I wish I had got that on video.
Yeah.
My talk with the QAnon guy who handed me this hope for the highway.
People will talk to you about all kinds of things when you drive this thing.
Including how there was a ship that wrecked in the Suez Canal and it's full of babies being transported so that people can drink their blood.
Well,
from a biker who calls himself Dog.
Oh wow, this really makes you think. Mentally, I am here.
Why don't most people have this peace and abundant life that God planned for us to have? Well, mostly because of systemic increasing wealth inequality. Okay, so our choices, such as premarital sex and drugs, get us like really far from God, who is holy. And there's stuff you can do to get closer to God, and then all you just need is Christ, and then you have to be able to jump over this too.
They made this into a game. It was called Mario.
Yeah, so if you jump over this, you can get on top of it, and there's actually an invisible block here.
That's the Holy Spirit.
It'll make this climbing plant that you can go up, and there's a bonus level, and then eventually you end up over here, but then Bowser's next, so... Watch out.
You know, if God is so holy, how come the hole isn't the destination here? I don't know.
Well,
I gotta workshop that joke. Come back to me later.
Patched up just like the ones in your soul will never be completely filled in.
Oh, it's grabbing on.
Binding on something.
It's the, it's this thing. Just
well,
watch
no, that,
out for that.
That's already come off. It's still, hey! Okay, is there a wire?
Yes.
There it is.
The clip was up here.
Yeah.
Did we break it?
Nope.
I'm not sure what that cable is.
Oh, no, this cable here is for... Oh, that's the antenna for the radio.
Oh, sweet. So we just wrap right around that.
Wow, look at that. We got to clean all this up.
This looks like a face. Does this look like a face?
I'll take it out this side.
It looks like the Shy Guys from Mario 2.
I got it.
Let's spit stuff out. There's a vent in there that closes.
Wow, look at all this crud.
It is... ugly and very dirty in there.
And it's ugly and dirty inside the car, too.
It's entirely possible that this Acty has never had its dashboard disassembled ever in its 27 years of life, and this is what accumulates.
This is good Japanese dust here. I'm trying to write in it. Okay, I'm gonna go wash my hand. Vroom, vroom! So this is the box of electronics from my childhood. We're looking for a switch. Look at this incredible solar panel.
Wow.
It is like melted as shit. This is a AA battery charger.
We can just use that to charge the car.
Yeah, I think this is a part of my dad's experiment to see which color LEDs fireflies would be attracted to. Oh, here's a speaker.
Nice.
Is it a tiny dump speaker?
It's a tiny dump speaker. I want a switch. Here's another speaker and a switch. Hey, we didn't have to go to Atlanta for a motor. So the 9-volt battery I needed for reasons was in the glove compartment, which was upside down. And so I made a mess. But I got my 9-volt battery, and I want to see if a circuit I built when I was 11 still works.
In case you want to turn this into an ambulance.
Yeah, I got you a siren set here. It's even got the blinking lights.
Just put somebody in the bed.
Best blinking lights.
We have some options, okay. So we've got these little guys, except these are buttons, not switches. So we would have to hold it down constantly if you want to listen to the radio. We've got this, which is a toggle. And it looks a little janky, but I think it fits with the aesthetic of the truck.
Yeah, I think that's 90s appropriate.
We've also got this like Frankenstein breaker. We could cannibalize this working circuit and take its little tiny switch, which is probably the most appropriate, but you might need this any day now. Okay. Some dust is coming out, so it's definitely...
Yeah, it's popping out this way.
There we go. Getting closer.
Yeah, now let's butcher it.
So I got our new wiring put together here. Nice professional looking heat shrink for this part that no one's gonna see once we put it in the truck. Next order of business is to connect one of these to go to the power, 12 volt power in the truck, and the other to go to the antenna, which probably just reuse this and put it as close as possible to the antenna in the truck.
We've got Jason here working very professionally with the wires.
Oh yes.
And then we have Tom, who is basically under the philosophy of, I make hole bigger!
As long as we glue it in cockeyed like this, it should be okay.
So, there was a misunderstanding about the design of this particular here component, where I thought we were going to make the side of the switch box flush with the thing, so I was just trying to make the hole as big as possible. Apparently that's not the design that we were going for. They stopped me while I wasn't completely done, and now we have like a bean-shaped hole. But I'm fine with it, and everybody seems to like it, so that's what's happening.
Wires don't pull out, because I think this cable is just slightly...
If you just tie it and bundle it up, it's enough.
Yeah, that's what I was
thinking. Oh, you know what? Here's something. There's nothing in that. See that?
This hole here. Oh yeah, that works too.
Do you see this?
Yeah. The dash doesn't connect to that.
Does it? I don't see how it could. They put that there because they knew that we were going to need it.
I'm going to shove the phone right in front of your face so you can't see what you're doing.
All right. You want to go under the...
Underwear.
under the brake hose here.
If you want to, just don't squeeze the hose real far.
So what we've done is we've hooked up the switch. It'll switch on or off the negative current. The positive current stays hooked up. Well, you know, there's no positive current if there's no negative current. We looped our antenna around the car's antenna, which is this wire that Jason is fiddling with now. Now we're just figuring out the least obtrusive way of wiring it so we don't interfere with more important car components.
The dash is going back in. So the speedo cable. There's a wiring harness too. You may want to put that in before the speedo because it's above it.
Okay, something very sticky down there.
I'm like I'm getting shit all over my fingers.
Well, you should probably take your fingers out your butt.
That's so stupid, and I'm laughing at it now, but I'm probably gonna edit that out of the video.
Oh, come on, that belongs in. Or just bleep it. You should probably take your fingers out your butt.
Actually, yeah, that'd be pretty good, yeah.
I think the speedo's line up, it doesn't feel like it's in there.
Okay, speedo cable possibly reattached.
Temp number 3.
So we fixed the issue with the speedometer, and we've got the dash mostly back on. We're almost back to having it restored to where it was when we started. That's just going to happen a few times.
Well, we can disconnect the battery.
Yeah, you could disconnect. That would probably be substantially less annoying. And then the last thing we're going to do is hook up our new radio mechanism to the inside of the dash. It's all inside here now. It lives inside the dashboard. It just has to be hooked up.
This damn switch won't come through the hole.
There we go. Ooh. Oh, come on. Yes! Yes!
It's a girl! Or a boy.
It's a radio.
It's done.
All right.
It's in the dash.
All right.
We now have...
I fucking hope it works. Cannot stress enough that we have not tested this. This is the test. We don't know if it will work.
But we will film again if it doesn't work.
I don't know which position the switch is.
I'll turn the radio on too.
And set it to the right channel. That would be
999.
Good.
999. Sounds great.
That's our radio. Well, it sounds perfect.
Yeah, that's horrendous. Is this supposed to be Muse?
So yes, learning French from a Scotsman. You definitely won't get an accent that way.
So, it works now. We don't know why. We didn't change anything. We've made the world's least reliable radio.
Not bad.
Oh. What did you do?
I did nothing. I literally did nothing.
It's never sounded that good. You've never been able to tell lyrics.
Still
before.
A bit quiet, though. I wish it could be a bit louder.
So just to recap where we are here. We have a phone hooked up to a mono audio cable that goes behind the dash into a little box that has an oscillator that converts that signal to AM radio, transmits it to the antenna, which is right in this column here, which comes back into the car under the dashboard into this radio, and we're hearing this glorious mono sound out of a single speaker. This is what, 6 hours of work?
At least I got tunes for the drive tomorrow.
No, this is actually going to make you drive a lot better. Or would it? All of our tests were run with the car battery on, but the ignition off. The moment Dave turned on the ignition, the transmitter shut down. We had accidentally wired it to a fuse circuit that turns off when the engine is running. Why is that even a thing that exists? So Dave did have to do his 6 hour drive in silence. Tune in next time when we're gonna attempt to wire the radio to a useful circuit.